Strawberries. We all want to make sure that we set them up right to be able to harvest as much as possible this summer. We know how to grow strawberries from seed, and better yet, we know how to grow them from runners. And for those of us with existing mature patches, we also learned in this video series how to divide and prolong the life of our strawberry mother plants. So now with loads of strawberry plants ready to go, let's get them into the garden and set them up for a bountiful summer. First, fill your container or bed with a quality organic potting mix to about 4 inches from the top. A few weeks ago, we divided our strawberry mother plants to make hundreds of new strawberry starters. But regardless of where you get your strawberry starter plants from, simply turn them upside down with your index and middle finger straddling the stem, and then have your other hand on the bottom of the pot. Strawberry plants usually just pop out without much effort. For most strawberry varieties, whenever planting a new, better container, you're going to want to space them about 4 to 6 inches apart. We do this to allow for maximum growth of those crowns over the course of the summer. Place your rooted strawberry plant, minus that pot, right on that level landing pad that we made earlier. Go ahead and plant out the rest of your bed, just like you see here. Next, we take that same organic potting mix and begin to fill in and around each plant. Even if you take your time here and you're very methodical with this, this step itself should only take you about 5 minutes. Most important part to remember here is not to bury those strawberry crowns. The crown itself has to stay above the soil level. Burying crowns makes them prone to rot. We're almost done. Before we can water this bed and call it a day, or move on to the next 50 beds, we have to mulch. Exposed soil in any garden is one of those things holding back a good crop from becoming a great crop. Mulching moderates temperatures, prevents the top biological layer from drying out, but it also allows us to water from above without completely blasting that soil everywhere. You can use grass clippings, shredded leaves, or really any organic matter that you can find. But my go-to mulch in the winter is coarse straw or hay. I got a few bags left, so I'm just gonna use it for all of my strawberries this year. I know it'll work great. Spread that mulch evenly and generously, at least 1 inch thick and up to 2 inches if you like. Your young strawberry plants are now ready for spring, and it won't be long until the summer harvest is here. Strawberries really are the quintessential summer fruit. In the Northern Hemisphere, they're super easy to grow, provided you understand their life cycle and give them the most basic of maintenance. Hey guys, thanks for watching this series. I do hope you learned a little bit on how to grow your own strawberries at home, and I do hope that those strawberry plants are able to give you those bountiful crops you deserve for years to come. Hey, thanks for watching, guys. If you're getting value in this and the other series that I'm doing on YouTube, hit those like, share, and subscribe buttons if you'd be so kind, and I'll see you in the next video.